In this video, we're going to cover everything you need to know about Halo MCC Season 7 Flight, as well as all the most important known issues going into this. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. So surprisingly, which not super surprisingly, but also surprisingly at the same time, Season 7 Flight was dropped on Friday for us guys, and this is actually going to be the shortest flight we've ever had for the MCC, which is kind of surprising, but I think they're trying to just get this out, just make sure to get some testing done before going into the final build. So like I said at the top of this video, we're going to cover all the important information of why they're doing this flight and all the known issues going into this as well. So if you guys like these news and informational videos and want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as it ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, make sure you tap subscribe. Let's get right into the content here. So what are the goals? What's the purpose of this flight? 343 states, the goals of this flight are to test our distribution pipeline, validate several new features coming to MCC, gather feedback on content listed below, and ensure all supporting systems are functioning properly in preparation for Season 7. In other words, they just want to make sure this works before putting it out to the public on the retail version of MCC, which is the whole purpose of these flights. So they give us a nice list of content that's going to be coming in with this flight, and it's a good amount of stuff, and I think we definitely want to test this out and showcase and give our thoughts on this as well. So for the flight content, for Season 7 content here, we have new content like Halo 3 Elite Armor customization, Halo 3 sword colors, and Halo 4 armor effects as well. On top of that, the Halo 4 Champion bundle has been added in, as well as new Halo 1 vehicle skins, which in our previous MCC flight video, we did cover everything like the Halo 3 armor sets, the new sword colors, the Halo 4 armor effects, as well as the Champion bundle, but we didn't touch on the Halo 1 vehicle skins, which I think there's only just a couple, but for example, here you can see they have the taxi, which is like a bright green kind of coloring to your awesome Warthog, looks fantastic, as well as the Amber Raven on top of that. We also have the camper skin, as well as the rescue skin for the Rocket Hog for CE. So not a crazy amount, but still worth noting. They've also made some major updates to Waterfall and Edge, which we'll talk about later in this video. There are still some issues lingering around with the map Edge especially. Here's a big one for all you CE fans, that they improve the visuals of Combat Evolved to match Legacy. If you don't know, there's been some issues with the visuals of the game. Here's an image showcasing what I'm talking about. So on the right here is the original Xbox version of CE. You can see a lot of detail within the world right there, especially in the water. Left side is the PC version that came out in 03 that was ported from Gearbox, which is the version that's on MCC. You can see how flat the water looks. It doesn't really look like water. It's just like a flat sheet of ice almost, or something weird like that. Another issue here showcasing that right here is on the right side, the original Xbox. You can kind of see how they brought in the brightness right there to kind of fade out that edge. But for some reason on the PC side of things, yeah, you can definitely see the geometry edge, not exactly visually immersive. Here's another example. This is the classic graphics within the MCC version. Here's the original CE version. You can see that waterfall, completely different aesthetic to that right there. A little different on this Halo ring, a big difference on this wall right here, and the bump mapping is hugely different, where the right side looks way more textured. There's also an issue with the Jackal shields not lighting up on the Gearbox version for some reason. Again, you can see like that lighting up in the top right there, really messing up the visuals right there. Also on the right side here, this is the classic graphics right here. Left side are the MCC graphics. You can kind of see how it doesn't really visually look as appealing as the original game did. But did they actually fix this? Well, I'm gonna test that out right now. This first example is from Attack on the Control Room. Keep an eye on the door and the texturing around the outside and how flat it looks. You don't really see, especially the texturing on the wall, especially of the door. But when you switch over to the new graphics in the flight, you can really see that texturing pop out much more in line with the classic visuals of CE. This next clip showcases 343 Guilty Spark, and take a look at the hands and also the texturing of the ground and the fog on this map. When we switch over to the flight version, the lighting is a whole heck of a lot better. The texturing and bump mapping on the ground is way more defined, and just overall, just a lot better. But it wasn't just campaign that got some love. Multiplayer got some love with some visual upgrades as well. We take a look at, for example, the map Hang 'Em High. Take a look at the texturing on the ground and the walls. Looks pretty flat and boring, but you switch to the Flight version, that depth and color really comes through on this map. It really mimics the original aesthetic of Hang 'Em High, as well as other multiplayer maps throughout CE. We also got an update for all you hardcore Combat Evolved fans. I know there's so many of you guys out there, but they made four major changes. Only play weapon ready effects for local players, disabled collision and material sounds for dropped weapons, disabled footstep sounds, only displayed kill feed messages if they pertain to a local player. Now for the gameplay content side of things of this flight, we have CE improvements right here is what they mentioned for the classic improvements. These are the levels that are part of it. Pillar of Autumn, Truth and Reconciliation, the Silent Cartographer, Assault on the Control Room, as well as 343 Guilty Spark. And in the multiplayer, you had Sidewinder, Damnation, Prisoner, Hang 'Em High, Chill Out, and Blood Gulch. You basically have the entire suite of Halo 3 multiplayer maps with the addition of Edge as well. And I played it on stream, guys, and I'll tell you that the Edge plays out very well now. The functionality of this map is so much better, but there still are some issues, which we'll get to later in this video. You have the regular suite of Halo 4 maps as well. And here's a big thing I'm sure you guys are questioning, how long is this flight going to last? Well, this is actually going to be the shortest flight we've ever going to have. This is only for this weekend in particular. It will end on May 24th at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So that's this Monday at 10 a.m. West Coast time in the U.S. is when this flight will conclude. This will be the shortest flight we've ever had. It's only for this weekend. But hopefully you guys save some time to jump out and play some Halo. This next section, I'll go over the known issues that are going on with this flight. And there are some of them a little more minor than others. I'm gonna go over the major ones. If you wanna read the entire thing, link in the description down below, guys, if you wanna check that out. While you're checking out the description, check out the links to my other socials right there. I got my Twitch, I got my Instagram, I got my Facebook, and everything in between if you guys wanna follow me on other platforms. Like I said, on Twitch, we do stream every Tuesday and Thursday evening, West Coast time as well. So if you ever wanna play some games with me, that's the best time to do it. So I highlighted a few here. We have Halo 3 about the map Edge. Two major issues really came out to me, saying thrown grenades can stick behind some environmental geometry, which is definitely odd. You want a little bit more consistency on your geometry for sure. And also FPS drops by 5 to 20% when the center control room and its hallways are in view. I actually noticed this quite a bit. There was a lot of geometry within the center area where you can basically see across the entire map. There's a lot of extra lines of sight and stuff, so I can see a lot of FPS drops. So that's kind of standard for that kind of stuff. I mean, we even have this happen right now with Stonetown in the H2A, where you're overlooking the map, your frames will just drop by like 50% almost. For Halo 4, there's some areas where the Mark V armor clips through the tech suit as it's part of the champion bundle. A lot of people in Halo 4 are gonna be wearing this, so it's actually a good thing to know. The Pixel DMR skin preview image does not match how it looks during gameplay as well. So if you're looking to have some awesome customization, this next bug I certainly noticed as well while playing during the flight. The birthday party audio plays at maximum volume regardless of distance. This can be extremely annoying when a lot of people are going to be running the grunt birthday audio, and if anyone dies with that on, you will hear it in your headphones no matter what distance you're at. So yeah, that'll definitely help out with the annoyances of that effect if you can help control the volume at whatever distance you're at. Another important thing, just to avoid some crashes for you guys as well during this flight, saying suspending the game, switching profiles, then resuming the game occasionally causes a crash. So keep in mind when you're also playing Halo to avoid doing that little sequence of motions. So those are all the main issues with this game and all the current content within the flight. Guys, it's only for the weekend, so jump on when you can. And trust me, it's a lot of fun. Playing Edge is actually a really fun map to play on, and actually does come up in the rotation quite often along with Waterfall. So jump in the flight, have some fun. Yeah, if you come across any bugs, make sure you leave some feedback on the Halo support site as well. So if you guys like these news and informational videos, or have been out of the loop for Halo for the last few days or so, or missing any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here. Can link to all my news and informational videos right there. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.